just the pulpit in the respective places. Amen. Especially to our minister, our Reverend Davis and our Reverend Higgs. Amen. For the house of mercy. Amen. And to the man of God, my dad.
Amen.
That we've come to celebrate on tonight. And I want everyone, if you can, please just stand to your feet. I know you were just standing, but let's celebrate God. Amen. For the life. Of this house, we continue to honor him tonight.
Yes.
And we come to celebrate with him on tonight. Amen. I thank God for my church family that chum with me. Y'all stand up real quick. Not all of them are here, but okay. I want to recognize them. Amen. Thank y'all. So let me see this. Quickly go with me to 1 Samuel chapter 16. When you got to preach for someone in the capacity of my dad, you really gotta do some study. For real. Because he is a scholar in the word.
Amen.
He set an example for us to do nothing less.
Amen.
And so when I travel, God has blessed me to travel and to bring forth his word and not the pastor. Every now and then, whenever I'm traveling, especially when I'm up in the Westchester area,
all
right, people say, they go trash. Because they can identify his characteristics when God used me to go forth.
Amen.
And while you're looking for 1 Samuel 16, I want to announce my grandmother, amen.
Amen.
For her glorious self. She's the last living grandparent I have on this earth, and I want to honor her.
Yeah.
1 Samuel chapter 16. We're going to start our reading at the first verse. And the scripture reads thus. The Lord said to Samuel, how long will you mourn for Saul? See, I have rejected him as king over Israel. Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I am sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem.
Yes.
I have chosen one of his sons to be king. But Samuel said, how can I go? Saul will hear about it and kill me. And the Lord said, take a heifer with you and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you what to do. And you are to anoint the one for me, the one that I indicate. And Samuel did what the Lord said. And when he arrived at Bethlehem, the elders of the town trembled. And when they met him, they asked, do you come in peace? Samuel replied, yes, I come in peace. I've come to sacrifice to the Lord. Consecrate yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice. And then he consecrated Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice. And when they arrived, Samuel saw Eliab and thought, surely this is the Lord's anointed standing before me. But the Lord had told Samuel, do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the thing that man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart. So far, the scripture. I'm going to take my text, and I'm going to go back to verse 7. It says, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the thing man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but But the Lord looks on the heart. So, Father, scripture, bow your head with me in prayer. Father, we bless you. And we glorify you for your word. We thank you tonight, God, that your word shall go forth under conviction, under your power. But most of all, under your discernment, Lord, to open the ears of your hearers. That they would be open to hear what you say to us on tonight. Speak tonight, God. Save somebody. Deliver somebody. Heal somebody. Set somebody free by the power of your word. We thank you that your word shall not fall to the ground, but it shall accomplish that which you sent to do. And Father, we promise to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want to minister to you from the topic on tonight, the educated man, the skilled man, and the anointed man.
Amen. Amen.
All right.
The educated man, the skilled man, and the anointed man. Amen. I use for a subtopic tonight, just to go at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
yeah.
He saved the best. For last. He saved the best for last. Here in this particular chapter, God begins to speak to the prophet Samuel. And he tells Samuel, listen, I need you to go down to Jesse's house because there I have chosen a new king. He starts off by asking Samuel a question, how long are you going to mourn for Saul? Seeing that I have rejected him for reigning over Israel. In other words, the Lord begins to tell Samuel, listen, Samuel, I understand that Saul has been in place for a long time. But now I have now gone down into my spirit and picked out another man who's going to begin to do things the way I wanted to do it. You gotta understand that Saul was a wicked king, man. He did everything that was not pleasing in the eyesight of God. When God got tired of Saul, he said, listen, I'm going to find me another man that's going to replace Saul. Don't ever think that we've been so saved and we've been in God so long and that God cannot replace us. So that was basically what God was telling Samuel, listen, stop mourning over Saul because I've already chosen myself another king. What you gotta understand is that at times we might pick things and we might choose things how I like it, but there's nothing like when God picks out something that's tailor-made just for us. So he told Samuel, he said, listen, I've already chosen myself a king. He said, go down to Jesse's house because at Jesse's house there's a king there that I want you to anoint. And so the Bible says that, to paraphrase them, for the sake of time, he goes down to Jesse's house. The Bible says that as he begins, he calls Eliab. Eliab is the oldest son of Jesse. And the Bible says that when Eliab comes before Samuel, that nothing happened. And what I want to point out to you is that when Samuel went to Jesse's house, he had an horn of oil with him. And anytime he had the horn of oil, he would lift up the horn over the candidate to see if the oil would flow. And so now the first son, Eliab, goes and he stands before the horn of oil and nothing happened. And God tells Samuel that, Samuel, listen,
preacher!
Now, Eliab's
Elijah.
And what I want to point out to you is that David's brothers were skilled and educated men.
That's right.
Listen,